Hello equation lovers and welcome. This video is the second in a series of four tutorial videos. If you haven't yet watched the first video in this series, we invite you to do that now before continuing with this one. In these four videos, we're showing the basics of using MathType and how to work with Word documents. This video in particular deals specifically with Word, but if you're using a different word processing application, it should be easy to adapt most, but not all, of the instructions that follow. Also, instructions for using MathType with other applications are available in the documentation. The basic concept of using MathType with Word is to type the text of your document using Word and type the math with MathType. We recommend using styled text for variables or simple expressions. Here are a few examples. Here's a simple variable, a simple equation, and a simple expression typed in Word. There are exceptions to this, such as writing a document that will be converted to Braille, but this is a good general technique because it will result in a smaller, more stable document. We also recommend you match your equation styles with your document styles. This process is not automatic. There are several topics in the MathType documentation that deal with this, but see the tutorial Fonts and Styles for a good starting point. To begin the steps of this tutorial, we'll start with a new document with a few words of text. Now we're ready to insert a MathType equation. If you installed MathType correctly, there should be a MathType tab on the ribbon in Word. Click this tab to give it focus, that is, bring it to the front. You can insert an equation using any of the commands on the Insert Equations group, but in this tutorial, we'll only mention the first two, Inline and Display. Let's insert an equation at the end of our text. Click Inline in MathType's Insert Equations group. MathType should open and its title bar will indicate a link to your Word document. We haven't saved the Word document yet, so it should be named Document 1 or some other number, but it will have a generic title. The MathType title bar will say Equation In, whatever the title of the document is, if you're using Windows, or Equation From Word, if you're on a Mac. If the MathType title bar does not say Equation In and simply says something like Untitled 1, like you see here, there is no link between MathType and Word. Close MathType and repeat the previous step. Let's insert a simple equation. To add the equation into the Word document, simply close MathType. The easiest way to do that is to click the red X in the upper right corner of the window. The first time you do it, you'll see this pop-up. You may like to see this confirmation every time, but many MathType users do not. If you'd rather the equation just go directly into the document, tick the Don't Show This Dialog From Now On checkbox and then click Yes. We just inserted an inline equation. Even if you weren't sure what this meant, it's probably obvious now that you've inserted the equation into your document. It places the equation in line with the text of your document. Now we'll see a display equation. Click the Display command on the Insert Equations group on the MathType tab in Word. MathType will open, but look at your Word document to see what else MathType did. Notice MathType inserted two new lines in the document and the insertion point, indicated by the flashing cursor, is two lines below the last text we typed. Rather than type a new equation this time, let's use one of the equations already on the MathType toolbar. Notice where in the document the formula is placed. It's in the center of the new line and the cursor is flashing on the line just below the newly inserted formula, ready for you to insert more text. That's it for now. In this video, we've seen the MathType tab in Word and we've seen how to insert inline and display equations. We hope this tutorial has been useful to you. Check out the other videos in this playlist. There's a link at the end, or better yet, subscribe to our channel so you'll always be aware of new content.